Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to start part two of our data series, where we are going to import data from external sources. The external sources that we are going to use today are going to be another Excel workbook, an Access database, a CSV file, a text file, and an XML file. So let's start with how to import just another Excel workbook. Right here is my sales data, and you are going to see the same sales data on every file that I import today, just so you can see how the format changes just a little bit. So this is my sales data. It is in a workbook called sales.xls. Okay, I'm going to close that right now, and I'm going to go into my import spreadsheet, and I'm going to click on this tab, and I'm going to go to data, get data from file from workbook, and I'm going to select this file right here that I just showed you, sales.xlsx, and I'm going to hit import. And when I do that, I will have a wizard appear. Over here, I'm being asked on which tab of the workbook is the data that I wish to import. I'm going to select all sales. And if I look over here to the right, I can see a preview of my data, and this does look correct. I'm going to hit the down arrow right here and go to load to, and I want to be able to tell Excel where I want to put this. And I'm going to import it as a table, but I want to add it to the existing worksheet that I'm on right now because I've already named this one from Excel. And I'm going to say okay, and you can see that all my data just came in as a table from a different Excel workbook. Next, I have an Access database where I have a table called sales. And you can see my sales data is now living in Access. So how would I import this table into my Excel spreadsheet? Well, I can close the database, click on my From Access tab, and this time I'm going to go up to the Data tab, go over to Get Data, and I'm going to select From Database because Access is a database. And I'm going to go over here where it says From Access Database, and I'm going to click the name of my database, which is import.accdb, and I'm going to click Import. And I'm going to be asked, what table do I wish to import from my Access database. In this case, I only have one table called sales, and I'm going to select that one, go down here to load to the existing worksheet, and I'm going to say okay. So there's my data coming from Microsoft Access. Next, I have a CSV file. CSV stands for comma separated values, and this is a very common format that many systems export to. So you can tell right here that the fields are not separated by a tab anymore, but they are separated by the commas right here. So I'm going to import this CSV file into Excel this time. So if I go back to the data menu and go to get data from file and go down again to text/CSV, I'm going to select the CSV file this time and go to import. And now I can see that my delimiter is a comma. And if I go down here to load, I'm going to load it to the existing worksheet and say okay. And you can see that my data came in from the CSV. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Next, I have a text file with all of my data, and I can see that my data is separated right here by a tab. So this is called a tab delimited file. We talked about delimiters in one of our recent videos. But to review that again, a delimiter is the same character being used to separate columns of data. So this is sales.txt, and I would like to import that into my Excel spreadsheet. So if I go back to Excel and I click on From Text, I'm going to go to my data tab, go down to get data from file, and this time I'm going to pick text, and I'm going to pick sales.txt and go to import. And I can see right here is where I select the kind of delimiter that I have for my text file. Excel already sensed that I was using a tab delimiter, so it defaulted right here to tab, which is correct. Again, when I go to load, I want to go to load 2, and I want to go to cell instead of A2. I would like to put it in A1. Click this button and say okay. And I can see that my sales data has been brought in again correctly. Next, I would like to be able to show you how to import data from the web. Sometimes the web uses a language called XML, and here's an XML file that I actually downloaded off of Microsoft's website, and you could download it too if you would like. But this one is looking at books instead of sales data because I did not have an XML file for that sales data. So in order to import this, I would go down to get data from file from XML. And in this case, I would pick books.xml and go to import. And I would would click book and I would see over here that these are the different kind of books that I'm going to import from that XML file. Again, if I choose load to, I can put this in the existing workbook and say okay. And you can see that the XML data has now been imported into my Excel spreadsheet. I also wanted to show you that you have an option to go up to the data tab and go to get data and say from database. And right here you have an option to import data from SQL Server. I do not have a SQL Server at the moment where I can show this to you, but if I click on that, you can see that this is the beginning of a wizard where you can type in the name of your SQL Server and the name of the database that you wish to connect to and some advanced options on here. So that's another way to bring data in from SQL Server. So in review today, we showed how to import a worksheet from another Excel workbook. We showed how to import a table from an Access database. We showed how to import a CSV. We showed how to import a tab delimited text file. And finally, we showed how to import an XML file. This XML file was borrowed off of the Microsoft website, and you can go there to get some test XML files if that's of interest to you. Next week, we are going to be looking at not just importing data, but linking data. The difference between importing data and linking data is that when you import, you have a copy of that data inside your spreadsheet. But when you link to it, you have a live link between the existing data and your Excel spreadsheet. So we'll look at how to do that next week. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.